KTDC, Sri M. Vijay Kumar, Senior Vice President of IATO, Sri E.M. Najib, President of KTM, Sri B.P. Matthew, Director of Kids, Dr. Rajasri Ajit, Principal Kids, Dr. B. Rajendran, Distinguished Guests, my dear friends and colleagues. It's a proud moment for kids and Kerala tourism. We are celebrating 30 years of kids under Kerala tourism. And in connection with that, we are organizing the International Conference on Global Trends in Tourism Studies. Kerala tourism has evolved and changed over the years. We began almost 30 years back with a humble beginning, a small state taking the first steps into the tourism world map. But over the years, the Department of Tourism, headed by the Honorable Ministers of Tourism, under the leadership of our Honorable Chief Ministers, and the private sector and the various stakeholders, they have put in efforts to put Kerala tourism on the world tourism map.
Provides a comforting shade to many people and families of this state, and also acts as a launching pad for young citizens to climb the echelons of the tourism industry. It gives me great pleasure to stand here today talking to you on this 30th birthday of our beloved child, KITS. Over the course of these many years, KITS has gone through various stages of growth, from being a dedicated institute for imparting knowledge in the field of tourism and travel studies to being a nodal agency for engineering sustainable and responsible tourism for the state of Kerala. KITS has indeed travelled a long road. With its headquarters at Trivandrum and its centres situated at Ernakulam, Trichur, Malayattur and Talasheri, KITS provides its unique services across the length and breadth of the state. Tailor-made courses such as MBA, BBA and BCom in Travel and Tourism, as well as short-term industry-driven courses in logistics, aviation and in adventure tourism, are provided to better equip the next generation to further enhance the growth of tourism in God's own country. One of the unique qualities of KITS is that our students get global exposure like none other.
സമാധാനിയായ സംസ്ഥാന ഗവർണർ ശ്രീ ആരിഫ് മുഹമ്മദ് ഖാൻ അവരുടെ വേദിയിലും സദസ്സിലുമുള്ള അഭിവന്ദ്യരായ ഗുരുജനങ്ങളെ സഹോദരി സഹോദരന്മാരെ, ടൂറിസം മേഖലയിൽ നിന്ന് സംഘടിക്കുന്ന പ്രിയമുള്ളവരെ, എല്ലാവർക്കും എൻ്റെ വിനീതമായിട്ടുള്ള നമസ്കാരം. ടൂറിസവും തൊഴിലും മികച്ച ഭാവി എല്ലാവർക്കും പ്രതീക്ഷാനിർഭരമായിട്ടുള്ള ഈ സന്ദേശമായിരുന്നു ഇത്തവണത്തെ ലോക ടൂറിസം ദിനത്തിൻ്റെ സന്ദേശം. ടൂറിസം രംഗത്ത് ശക്തമായി നിലയുറപ്പിച്ചിട്ടുള്ള നമുക്ക് ഏറെ പ്രചോദനമേകുന്നതാണ് ഈ സന്ദേശം. ടൂറിസം കൊണ്ടുള്ള ഗുണം പ്രദേശവാസികൾക്ക് അനുഭവവേദ്യമാകണമെന്ന ആശയം നേരത്തെ തന്നെ പ്രഖ്യാപിച്ച സംസ്ഥാനമാണ് കേരളം. ഉത്തരവാദിത്ത ടൂറിസം മിഷൻ രൂപീകരിച്ചതും തൊഴിലവസരങ്ങൾ കൂടുതൽ പ്രദാനം ചെയ്യുന്നതിനുള്ള നിർദ്ദേശങ്ങളടങ്ങിയ പുതിയ ടൂറിസം നയം ആവിഷ്കരിച്ചതുമെല്ലാം ഇതിൻ്റെ ഭാഗമായാണ്. 36,000 കോടി രൂപയാണ് ടൂറിസം മേഖലയിൽ നിന്നും നമുക്ക് കഴിഞ്ഞ വർഷം കിട്ടിയ വരുമാനം. 15 ലക്ഷത്തോളം ആളുകളാണ് ഇന്ന് ടൂറിസം മേഖലയിൽ ജോലി ചെയ്യുന്നത്. നമ്മുടെ സംസ്ഥാനത്തിന്റെ വളർച്ചയിൽ ടൂറിസം മേഖലയുടെ പ്രാധാന്യമാണ് ഈ കണക്കുകൾ ബോധ്യപ്പെടുത്തുന്നത്. അതിഥി ദേവോഭവ എന്ന ആപ്തവാക്യം അക്ഷരാർത്ഥത്തിൽ പ്രായോഗികമാക്കുന്നിടത്താണ് നമ്മുടെ ടൂറിസം മേഖലയുടെ വികസനം യാഥാർത്ഥ്യമാകുന്നത്. അടിസ്ഥാന സൗകര്യ വികസനം സർക്കാർ ഒരുക്കുന്നതിനൊപ്പം സ്വകാര്യ സംരംഭകരെ പ്രോത്സാഹിപ്പിക്കുകയും ചെയ്താൽ മാത്രമേ ടൂറിസം മേഖലയ്ക്ക് മുന്നോട്ട് പോകാനാകൂ. അതുവഴി കൂടുതൽ തൊഴിലവസരങ്ങൾ ഒരുക്കാനുമാകും. ആഗോള തലത്തിൽ തന്നെ തൊഴിലില്ലായ്മ രൂക്ഷമായ സാഹചര്യം ഗൗരവത്തോടെ കാണണം.
ട്രെയിൻഡ് ഹ്യൂമൻ റിസോഴ്സസ് ടു കാറ്റർ ടു ദ ട്രാവൽ ആൻഡ് ഹോസ്പിറ്റാലിറ്റി സെക്ടർ. It was the government led by former Chief Minister Sri E. K. Nayanar and Tourism Minister Sri P. S. Srinivasan that decided to set up a world-class travel and tourism institute on the lines of the Indian Institute of Travel and Tourism Management. On September 27, 1988, the Department of Tourism Kerala started Kerala Institute of Travel and Tourism Management as a southern chapter of Indian Institute of Travel and Tourism Management. This was the turning point of Kerala tourism. The trained professionals from KITS started their career in various sectors such as travel agencies, tour operations and allied sectors, and some of them started their own enterprises. The International Conference on Global Trends in Tourism Studies is conceived in the backdrop of India being the host country for UNWTO World Tourism Day celebrations, with the theme of the year being Tourism and Jobs, a Better Future for All. The proposed conference intends to start with a plenary session, a retrospective journey on 30 years of Kerala tourism. Kerala declared tourism as an industry in 1986, and the plenary session is conceived in this context. ലോക നിലവാരത്തിലുള്ള മാനവ വിഭവശേഷി ലഭ്യമാക്കിയതാണ് കിറ്റ്സിന്റെ പ്രധാന ലക്ഷ്യമായി സർക്കാർ കാണുന്നത്. വിവിധ മേഖലകളിൽ തൊഴിലവസരം ഉണ്ടാക്കുന്നതിനോടൊപ്പം സ്വയം സംരംഭകരെയും തൊഴിൽ ദാതാക്കളെയും സൃഷ്ടിക്കാനും കിറ്റ്സിന് സാധിക്കുന്നുണ്ട്. നൂതനമായ നിരവധി കോഴ്സുകൾ സർക്കാരിന്റെ ഭരണകാലത്ത് കിറ്റ്സിൽ ആരംഭിച്ചിട്ടുണ്ട്. ഭാവിയിൽ കിറ്റ്സിനെ ടൂറിസം രംഗത്തെ ഗവേഷണ കേന്ദ്രമാക്കാനും നടപടികൾ സ്വീകരിക്കുമെന്നതുകൂടി ഈ അവസരത്തിൽ അറിയിക്കാൻ ഞാൻ ആഗ്രഹിക്കുകയാണ്. കഴിഞ്ഞ വർഷങ്ങളിൽ ഉണ്ടായിട്ടുള്ള വലിയ മാറ്റം, നിങ്ങൾക്കറിയാവുന്നതുപോലെ ഒരുപാട് പ്രതിസന്ധികളിലൂടെയാണ് കേരളത്തിലെ ടൂറിസം മേഖല കടന്നുപോയത്. ഓക്കി, അതിനുശേഷം നിപ വൈറസ്, പിന്നെ കനത്ത പ്രളയം, ഇതിനെല്ലാം അതിജീവിച്ച് നമുക്ക് വളർച്ച നേടിയെടുക്കാൻ സാധിച്ചിട്ടുണ്ടെന്നുള്ളത് സന്തോഷകരമായ കാര്യമാണ്. ഒരാഴ്ചയ്ക്ക് മുമ്പാണ് കസാഖിസ്ഥാന്റെ തലസ്ഥാനമായിട്ടുള്ള അസ്താനയിൽ വെച്ച് ലോക അടിസ്ഥാനത്തിലുള്ള അവാർഡുകൾ, 3 അന്തർദേശീയ അവാർഡുകൾ കേരള ടൂറിസത്തിന് ലഭിക്കുകയുണ്ടായി. ഇന്നലെ 2 ദേശീയ അവാർഡുകൾ അടക്കം നമ്മുടെ സംസ്ഥാനം 7 വരുന്ന അവാർഡുകൾ ഡൽഹിയിൽ നിന്ന് നേടുകയുണ്ടായി. ഇങ്ങനെ നമ്മുടെ സംസ്ഥാനത്തെ സംബന്ധിച്ചിടത്തോളം ടൂറിസം വ്യവസായം നമ്മുടെ നാടിന്റെ തന്നെ ഭാവിയെ ബാധിക്കുന്ന ഒന്നാക്കി മാറ്റിയെടുക്കാൻ, നമ്മുടെ നാടിന്റെ ഭാവി ഭാഗതയിൽ നിർണ്ണയിക്കുന്ന ഏറ്റവും സുപ്രധാനമായിട്ടുള്ള മേഖലയാക്കി മാറ്റിയെടുക്കാനുള്ള ആത്മാർത്ഥമായിട്ടുള്ള ടൂറിസം രംഗത്തെ പ്രവർത്തനങ്ങൾക്ക് കിറ്റ്സ് അതിൻ്റെതായിട്ടുള്ള പങ്ക് നിർവഹിക്കുന്നുണ്ടെന്ന ചാരിതാർത്ഥത്തോടു കൂടി എന്റെ അധ്യക്ഷ പ്രസംഗം ഞാൻ അവസാനിപ്പിക്കുന്നു. എല്ലാവർക്കും എന്റെ വിനീതമായിട്ടുള്ള നമസ്കാരം.
Your Excellency Governor of Kerala, Sri Arif Mohammed Khan, Excellency Tourism Minister of Kerala, prominent and distinguished guest, dear KIT friend, ladies and gentlemen, very good morning. I'm absolutely delighted to come back to our God's own country, Kerala, which is one of the most sought after tourist destination in this planet. And first of all, I'd like to express my sincere appreciation to KIT for your kind invitation to join with you all this morning. And it is such a great pleasure to share a few words of thanks and appreciation on occasion of this international conference on global trends in tourism studies here in Siravana Sapuram, Kerala, India. I hope I pronounced city name correctly. Dear friend and excellency, UNWTO maintains such an excellent working relationship with KIT, and who has been keenly working on the development of Kerala tourism over the past 30 years. And we also wish to thank KIT, in particular our UNWTO good friend Dr. Adif, for her active and personal contribution into our program of work of UNWTO, for being both, as she already mentioned, being a board of director and also regional vice president of UNWTO official member. And UNWTO extends warmest congratulations to the Kerala tourism for receiving such a many the National Tourism Award yesterday. I witnessed it and I was very tired of it. And if I may look a little bit timid and tired, please excuse me. I catch 5:30 in the morning flight in order for me to make this inauguration. And Kerala Tourism also received UNWTO Ulysses Award in such an iconic project, Kumarakum Initiative. And this is indeed the positive outcome of many years of effort and hard work delivered by the King. And Excellency, ladies and gentlemen, we are all currently living in the age of travel. And international tourist arrivals have soared from just 25 million in 1950 to 1.4 billion last year in 2018. And the center of gravity of this era of travel is fast shifting to Asia. And India plays a huge part in the region's tourism success, with over 15 million have visited the country in 2017. And of course, Kerala tourism certainly has contributed effectively and professionally to the overall growth of visitors to both the country as well as the region. With this big picture in mind, my main objective, the reason why I'm here, is to make sure that UNWTO is here to serve you. And we are not, UNWTO is not our organization, it is your organization. So I just want to assure you and keep all friends that we are ready to serve whatever area that Kerala Tourism and keep identify important to work with UNWTO. So with that, I hope that the conference will be successful and dynamic discussion will be made and we find conclusion which I believe could be a good food for thought and on how and why the tourism matter for better future for all. Thank you.
Honorable Governor of Kerala, Sri Arif Muthan sir, Honorable Minister for Tourism, Sri Kadagamudi Surendran, other distinguished dignitaries on the dais, and friends. The tourism industry of Kerala is extremely happy that such a distinguished personality, Sri Arif Muthan, as the Governor of Kerala. He has got great knowledge about the travel industry, as he had held positions as Indian Minister for Civil Aviation and Energy in the beginning of the 90s. As a representative of the tourism industry and as a person who has been associated with the Kerala Institute for Travel and Tourism Studies, I am happy and excited to be part of this Pearl Jubilee celebrations today. I remember attending the inaugural function of KITS 30 years ago while Sri Anand Kumar Iyer was at the helm of affairs of KITS as a director. For the tourism industry all along, the biggest challenge was getting the well-qualified and trained personnel, and KITS filled up that gap by producing excellent professionals. One of the reasons for the fast growth of tourism in Kerala was the human resources support from KITS. We have been talking about the experience which the Kerala Tourism has been sharing to many travelers from the beginning of 30 years past. Those days, we did not have any infrastructure, but we had the nature, we had the culture, and we had the cuisine. With that, we have attracted the people to come to Kerala. Then the people, the personalities of the tourism industry have given excellent experience because they have been well trained for that. With that experience, with the word of mouth publicity, Kerala has slowly become a super brand and became one of the best of destinations in the country. I believe that KITS has the potential to grow in email and size to become a tourism and travel university serving the South Asian region. It can attract scholars and students from the countries in the region. I have been raising this possibility repeatedly for the last several years. Representing the Indian Association of Tour Operators and the National Tourism Advisory Council, I extend the best wishes and felicitate the institute that is celebrating its first jubilee. per Jubilee. Once again, my congratulations to Dr. Rajasri Ajit and her efficient team in managing kids very well. Very well supported by Ravi George, Balakiran and Honorable Minister and Chairman of KTDC. Once again, congratulations. Thank you very much.
Good morning, His Excellency Sri Arif Muhammad Khan Ji, Honorable Governor of Kerala, Sri Kalakambalu Suryodhan, Honorable Tourism Minister, Sri Blue Health Deputy Director, UNWTO, other innovators, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, the students of KITS. I am very happy that the Kerala Institute of Tourism and Travel Studies, KITS, is organizing a two-day international conference on Global Trends in Tourism Studies, A Better Future Tour, to commemorate its 13th anniversary celebrations. Since tourism has been declared as an industry in 1986, Kerala tourism has emerged as one of the key players in the world tourism scenario, and now has become a most sought-after all-season global tourism brand. In Kerala, tourism significantly contributes towards socio-economic progress of our state through employment generation, foreign exchange earnings, infrastructure development, and community upliftment. Over these years, Kerala tourism has grown into an industry with an annual turnover of, I think, 34,000 crore and provides employment to 25 lakh people in the state. This would not have been possible but for the synergy between Kerala government and the various stakeholders of the tourism industry. To be more effective, Kerala tourism needs stronger industry government partnership to harness the collective efforts to all tourism industry stakeholders. I am sure this conference will enable the tourism stakeholders to actively engage with Kerala tourism with your innovative ideas, efforts and support to contribute to the shared goal of building a more vibrant tourism industry and sustaining its growth, especially in the wake of the devastating Delhi Kerala disaster last year. Human resource is an important pillar of tourism economy. KITS over the economy. KITS over the last 3 decades has blossomed into one of India's finest tourism schools in the country. Through its industry-friendly and innovative ways, KITS facilitates students not only to understand what they can do in the tourism world, but giving them the much needed tools and the skill essential to become better managers who will add value to tourism trade even as they do well for them. Kerala Tourism, while I congratulate KITS for your efforts in organizing this conference, my request is to make this a billion event on alternate years of Kerala Travel March. I wish this conference all the very best and I wish the tourism industry a successful season ahead.
Kerala, Sri Arun Guru, thanks sir. Honorable Tourism Minister, Sri Kalakambalu Suryodhan sir. Other dignitaries on the dais, students and dear friends. Yesterday in Delhi, during the World Tourism Day celebration and the National Award Distribution Ceremony, our Vice President of India, Sri Venkata Naidu, during his speech, shared his experience traveling different countries, the purpose of his travel to experience the world. Like the Secretary General of UNWTO and even our Union Minister of Tourism also shared their views on tourism, the future tourism. Dear friends, this is a time the new trend is. Tourists are traveling to experience, not just to see the places, experience the nature, experience the human nature, humans, along with the life. This is a new trend. I wish all success for this seminar and I appreciate the initiatives of KITS and the Tourism Department, Government of Kerala, all initiatives to make tourism a great success in Kerala. Thank you.
In tourism studies is very, very relevant today. Tourism, in my view, is one of the largest cultural exchanges happening across the world.
Because of high literacy rate. That remark has always stuck in my mind. Kerala is known for high literacy rate. But today when I went Vidya, then my admiration for the people of Kerala has been enhanced. That they trust their youngsters, they trust them with the responsibilities. She is a student here and she has been elected as the ward councillor. My congratulations. And I have already told you, please sit down. I would advise you, not only you, other students as well, particularly those who aspire to be public speakers, that it has been Winston Churchill was no friend of India, but he was a great speaker. Now I come to the formal speech. No, before that, I must also compliment Mr. Minister, you, your secretary, your director, and everybody associated with the tourism department, because I believe today some announcement has been made and you have been given two national awards for promoting, which I do not know if you mentioned about it. Anybody mentioned? You mentioned about it. Good. Sorry. What is that? But I must compliment you. You deserve kudos for that. It's a pleasure for me to inaugurate this international conference on global trends in tourism studies organized by CHEDS, an autonomous institution under the government of Kerala. At the outset, I would like to convey my appreciation for the efforts made by CHEDS in organizing this seminar, which echoes the global theme, Tourism, a Better Future for All. Ever since its inception in 1988, Kerala Institute of Tourism and Travel Studies has been imparting quality education and training in travel and tourism, thereby effectively addressing the manpower requirements of the tourism industry. As an affiliate member of the United Nations World Tourism Organization since 2012, it has implemented responsible tourism in Kerala for 5 years and enabled the state to win the prestigious UNESCO Award in Public Policy and Governance for Kumarakom in 2013. That's not just tourism, because earlier the speakers have made reference to that Sanskrit phrase, Atithi Devo Bhava, guest is God. And we must keep the guest as God, because we have inherited a cultural legacy which sees God in the creation of God. The Upanishads place guests at par with the mother, father, and the Acharya. Kerala's success in tourism was inspired by a combination of nature's bounty, cultural wealth, and above all, people's readiness to share with the world the beauty of the land's heritage. It was this attitude which made the world proclaim Ente Keralam Etra Sundaram, our Kerala so beautiful. Tourism has the potential to drive Kerala's economy forward by gaining global attention. I am happy to know that Kerala tourism has registered a very strong global presence on the social media. After the setbacks suffered due to natural calamities in the last 1 year, we are now on the path of rebuilding our tourism industry. Kerala must go with the global trend of rebuilding of destinations through destination management organizations, which will be active throughout the year. From the pattern of disasters we have suffered, it is clear that rebuilding has to restart by revitalizing the areas in the western parts, which is a major determinant of tourism of Kerala. Technology and artificial intelligence could show some innovative models in the use of modern technology in providing tourism services. Equally important for the industry is ensuring ease of doing business in tourism, especially at the small and medium level.
I hope that creative exchanges and interactions between the academia and the industry would go a long way in helping our tourism sector to reset its priorities and in guiding the professionals to update their skills in tune with the global trends. I hope this seminar would produce practical recommendations for the industry as well as the students and researchers of tourism studies. I also wish that KITS would conduct research into the social and cultural implications of our tourism initiatives. I compliment the students, teachers, and the staff of KITS for organizing this event in a befitting manner. My best wishes to all the delegates and participants of this seminar, Loka Samasta Sukhino Bhavantu. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.
Honorable Governor of Kerala, Honorable Minister of Tourism, Cooperation and Tourism, respected MLA, and other dignitaries on the dais and off the dais. It is my privilege to propose the vote of thanks on this very special occasion. First of all, I would like to express our sincere gratitude to Honorable Governor of Kerala, Sri Arif Muhammad Khan, for his esteemed presence and for sharing valuable thoughts with us. It will be surely inspire kids and Kerala tourism industry without doubts. Next, I would like to thank Honorable Minister and Chairman of KITS, Sri Kadamballi Surendran, for his valuable support and guidance. I hereby acknowledge our sincere thanks to Sri Shivakumar, V.S. Shivakumar, MLA. And on behalf of KITS family, our thanks to Sri K. Kurpan, Deputy Secretary, Regional Department of Asia, UNWTO, and Srimadhi Rani George, IAS, Secretary Kerala Tourism and Vice Chairman KITS, Sri M. Vijay Umar, Chairman KTDC, Sri David Matthew, and Sri E. M. Najib, and our Director Rajasri Ajit, our student and counselor Srimadhi Vidya Mohan. I take this opportunity to extend our gratitude to all industry partners for their constant support and encouragement. We offer our sincere thanks to all delegates, invitees, audience, including our staff, students, parents, well-wishers and media persons. Once again, I thank all for being here and extending your support.